Everly, can you say good morning?
I can open it.
What are you eating?
Waffles.
And what else? Waffles and what else?
Blueberries.
Blueberries. Everybody, and welcome back to the vlog. Oh, I feel out of breath. I just ran up our steps and back down our steps because I forgot something. Back up our steps again. So yeah, that will definitely make you out of breath when you're 22 weeks pregnant. Anyway, today is Thursday, March the 25th, and we are getting ready to leave here in a few minutes. It's almost lunchtime around here. Two of the girls have a well checkup at the doctor today. Bethany and Holly both have their well checkup today. This has been scheduled for like a month. Unfortunately, it's raining, and it's raining pretty hard today. But anyway, we gotta get out and take them to the doctor, do their checkup. Hopefully that won't take long and everything will go well there. And then when we leave, I think that's all that we have to do, pretty sure. And then we'll just come back home and then pick up on some school stuff where we left off this morning. But yeah, that's kind of what's planned for today is a well checkup and schoolwork. And it's just a rainy, rainy day. And actually, it's supposed to rain tomorrow. Tomorrow's Friday. It shouldn't be allowed to rain on Friday.
And I don't have to get
shots
until I'm
11. Yeah. Bethany may have to just get one. Oh, I guess she fell. Thank you. So far it's going good. Holly's 41 pounds and Bethany is 40 pounds. All right, y'all, so it is the next day now. I did not finish vlogging any yesterday after the doctor, and it's actually lunchtime here today. I took a shower and washed my hair, but I have not blow dried or straightened it, so my hair looks super crazy when I don't do anything to it. Anyway, I'm fixing lunch right now. I've got fish sticks and fries in the oven. Everybody thought that sounded good today, so that's what I'm doing. We haven't had fish sticks, y'all, in like forever, in like a very long time. So we're having fish sticks and fries for lunch. And it was actually supposed to storm and rain again all day today, but it's a pretty day. Like the sun's coming out and yeah, it just looks like a normal sunny day. The only thing is it's super muddy outside because it did pour down rain all day yesterday. So there's lots of mud everywhere. The dog is super muddy. So yeah, they gotta stay inside since it's muddy, but this is pretty outside. And I just made some tea in the new tea jug. Unfortunately though, I was already making tea and I went to the pantry to get sugar out and we had just a very little bit of sugar. So this is pretty much gonna be unsweet tea, but I had already started, so it will. We've got just a tad bit of sugar in there, so it's not technically sweet tea, but you know, maybe a little bit. Okay, so we just got finished with lunch. That was good. That was actually really good. But I came in Amy and Bethany's room where it's quiet for a minute. So Bethany and Holly both had a good checkup yesterday. Everything looked good, all that stuff. The only thing is Bethany did have a little bit of protein in her urine. I don't know if it was a little bit. They didn't really specify. But she does have some protein in her urine. So they want me to bring her back Thursday at 2:15 for a recheck. So we just pretty much go in there and recheck her urine. And praying that her levels are normal and that there's no protein in her urine then. Hopefully it was just that she had not drank enough that morning or something like that. Because the doctor said sometimes it could be that the child has not drank enough or they kind of like overplayed and overdid it with exercise. Things like that. So I guess we'll just see this coming Thursday. But yeah, I'm just praying for good results for her this Thursday. It's funny, they're only 1 pound apart. Holly is 41 pounds and Bethany is 40 pounds and they're 2 years apart. But I've been trying to debate on what I want to do this afternoon since it actually did not rain. So first of all, let me just start here. We are going to be like making room for the new baby. So this is Amy and Bethany's room, which is a mess right now, but they both have twin beds in here. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be getting the twin beds out of here and doing bunk beds where it takes up less space, and actually order their bunk beds the day before yesterday. And they'll be here Tuesday. And they're also getting a bigger dresser for their room, and that'll be here soon. So that's pretty much all that's getting done to their room is bunk beds and a dresser. And then Natalie and Everly's room, I am going to take one of these twin beds and give it to Natalie so she can upgrade to a big girl bed now. And then we'll just take the other twin bed in here and probably just put it in storage, you know, just in case we need it in the future or something like that. Everly will remain in her crib, and they're also get a new dresser for their room, one a little bit bigger, because I will be having Natalie, Everly, and Josie's stuff in one room. So I need to make room to put Josie's clothes and her diapers and all of that stuff in that bedroom. So that is kind of a project that we're working on right now here at the house, is making room for baby number 9 and getting room situated. That's exciting to me. I love organizing and getting things ready for the baby. And Amy, Bethany are like super excited to get bunk beds. They actually had bunk beds at our old house that Josh built them, but we had to leave them there when we left. And they like their twin beds, but they just love bunk beds. They love it. And plus, it's going to free up floor space, things like that in here. So I'm excited to show y'all. So anyway, what I was thinking about doing this afternoon is doing a Target order just for like curbside pickup, and getting sheets for their bed. I think it was sheets. Yeah, I think it was just sheets for Amy, Bethany, and Natalie. For their beds. So I'm not sure if I'm gonna do that yet or not. Maybe wait till next week, because y'all were taking spring break next week. But this year I was like, you know what, I really want to take spring break and just enjoy this time off. So next week is spring break for us, and that'll give me some time to really work in rooms and organize. Actually, I can't show you their room right now because Everly is in there taking her nap after lunch. So when she wakes up, I will show y'all the closet. So Kylie is in here baking us some brownies. My friend gave me this brownie mix in a jar. It's got the recipe there, and it had all the ingredients you need here, except eggs, of course. So she is making this. She asked if she could make it. I said, sure, go ahead. So yeah, we're excited to eat brownies in a minute.
Yes, Mom.
You're doing such a good job.
Okay, Mom, that's enough.
Okay, so she's awake, and let me start by saying this is not anywhere near perfect or done. As you can see, I've just got blankets piled up in that basket. I need to do something with that shelf right there. But for now, this is what I did. So I ordered one of these little cubbies off of Amazon. It was only like $31, and I turned it on its side, and I'm using this little cubby here for books. I need to add a few more books there. Natalie actually put her purse in there, her two purses. But I'm actually going to get a little basket for all of their bows that are going to go right there. This is extra diapers and wipes, a whole extra bag of diapers, and all of the girls' helmets to ride with their scooters. So anyway, I put that there, and I just think this made the biggest difference, because if y'all would have saw this before, kind of all the stuff you see here was just kind of piled on this shelf, like literally just laying there. And I was like, that would be the perfect thing for this shelf here. And then I'm going to get some kind of baskets or something to go here for blankets. Start putting Josie's diapers there and her wipes, and just kind of getting things ready for her. Below that, I've had this shoe box in here since we moved here like a year ago. And it works because I keep all of the girls' church shoes in this box, except for my 3 oldest. But everybody else's goes in here. And that way on Sunday mornings, I'm not running around like a crazy lady like I used to, looking for church shoes. Now, unless Everly comes in here and tries on shoes. Now, that little girl loves to put shoes on and walk around. Otherwise, they stay here. There's a couple of bags in there that need to come out. But yeah, and just a few toys. And I'm trying to think about what to do right here. If you can tell, see, like, this shelving was already in the closet when we moved in here. So I'm trying to think of something to go right here that would help even more with organization. I don't know yet. That's my carrier. I need to kind of find another place for that too. But anyway, so yeah, if y'all have any ideas of what I should do right here in this space, let me know. I'm thinking about maybe getting a taller one of those and some bins to stick in it, and then just like putting maybe socks and baby leggings and sleepers and things like that in it. So I'm not sure. So that space is kind of open for discussion. I don't know what to do with it yet. But yeah, Amy and Bethany also have that same exact closet layout, like just like they have the doors, the shelving. So I'm thinking about doing the same thing in their room to kind of organize their closets a little bit better. But yeah, I just need to order one of those from Amazon. They're literally like $30 or $31, so it's really inexpensive. to kind of get your closet organized. I will try to remember and link that down below, the one that I got. Oh, look at that. Emily and Holly laid their babies down in the crib to sleep. How cute is that? The babies are napping and they look so real. Anyway, y'all, I think that's going to be it for today's vlog. I thank y'all so much for watching. If you're new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button down below. Give this video a thumbs up and I'll talk to you in the comments. Bye.